सर शुरू करें?
या
मेरे वेबकैम में थोड़ा परेशानी है तो इसलिए मैं स्विच ऑफ है। ओके मानस जी, इंस्ट्रक्टर्स एंड मेंटर्स ऑफ दिस कोर्स ग्रुप कैप्टन अशोक कुमार जी, डॉक्टर आकाशदीप भारद्वाज, डॉक्टर संग्राम पानीग्रही, मिस्टर श्रीधर अय्यर, मिस्टर ऋषिकेश ओझा जी एंड डियर पार्टिसिपेंट्स, आई वेलकम यू ऑल टू दिस इंडक्शन प्रोग्राम फॉर दिस 4-week online training program on digital forensics starting from today. More than 800 participants registered for this online training program. This is the second cycle of the program. The first cycle was conducted in July this year, and you will be glad to know that more than 3,000 participants attended that program. This online training program is offered through a Moodle-based e-learning platform. Most of the participants are attending this MOOC through this course website. An app is also configured for this course, and the link for downloading the app is shared via Telegram group and announcement section of this course page. 4 live discussion forums will also be conducted through Zoom every Saturday at 6 p.m. to resolve the queries. Dr. Akashdeep Bharadwaj, Dr. Sangram Panigrahi, Group Captain Ashok Kumarji, Mr. Shridhar Iyer, myself, and Mr. Rishikesh Ojhaji will respond to the queries posted on the discussion forum and live sessions. This is a 4-week online training program. At the end of every week, a quiz will be released. There are total 4 quizzes, and the participants have to clear all quizzes with more than 50 or more percent for receiving the certificate of participation. In case you are not able to clear the quiz with the desired marks in your first attempt, you can attempt again till you get the satisfactory marks. Now I invite all the experts for their short introduction, starting with Group Captain Ashok Kumarji. Ashok Kumarji.
Very good morning to you, Jitendraji, and all the participants. It's a real privilege to be associated with this forum. I am very appreciative of creating this platform and making this awareness of how cyber forensics can help us in decoding and reaching the cyber criminals. Idea is in these 4 weeks, expectations should not be that you'll be made cyber forensics experts. It's a very vast field, and each vertical, let it be Windows or Linux or Mac or mobile forensics, every vertical has its own specialty and requires very high specialization. Expecting in 4 weeks to become expert will be very, very unreasonable. However, to in case of a cyber incident, in case of a cyber crime, the how to preserve the evidence so that it can be admissible in court of law, we call it in terms of forensic language, the first responder. So in case we can preserve the evidence so that it is admissible in court of law, the criminals can be punished. So I wish all the participants all the very best. And whatever we little experience we have in this field, would love to share with everyone during sessions on Saturdays. Thank you, Manasji. Thank you, Jitendraji, for involving me. Every session has been a learning experience for us. And okay, my voice is not clear. Somebody posted in chat, my voice is not clear. Hello?
Ha, we can hear you, sir.
Okay, somebody posted in chat, my voice is not clear. As it is, I'm having a very bad cough and cold. So pardon me for that. What I was trying to say is, kindly do not expect to become cyber forensic expert, but we'll definitely try to sensitize the environment that in case of a cyber incident, one should know step 1, 2, 3, 4, what are the steps to be taken so that the evidence is preserved and same can be produced in court of law and criminal can be brought to the justice. So that is going to be the purpose. I wish all the participants and as my professor in college used to say, that you can remain a teacher and a student throughout your life. It's going to be an equal learning session for us. The kind of queries students give us, the learners give us, it's really a good experience for us. Thank you so much for making part of this journey. Over to you, Jitendraji. Thank you so much.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much. Now I invite Manasji to address the students, please. Manasji.
Very good morning, Dr. Jitendra Pandey, Uttarakhand Open University. Ashok Kumar ji, lead instructor and mentor for this MOOC, and all other instructors and mentors who are joined this program or unable to join today due to preoccupation. However, they are with us. And all the participants who enrolled to this 4-week faculty development MOOC on digital forensic. This, as we know, digital forensic already, Ashok ji told, digital forensic, it is a need of the era. Maybe it is starting from the preliminary level or it may be advanced level as per the requirement of the individual to individual is concerned. This is quite important in this particular time is concerned. As you understand, every day we are spending maximum time on online with your mobile phone or with your computer at home as desktop or movable as laptop. So, and we are playing a lot of interactions through internet. This, what I believe always, while we are using this one, we are sharing many informations knowingly and unknowingly. And the main concern is that sometimes we are thinking these informations are very easygoing way that, okay, this is my name, I can spell out to everyone. Oh, my number, mobile number, I can share to everyone. Email ID, okay, I can share to everyone. that every one thing is main concern to make you aware that through this course to understand who are they, these everyones. This everyone is your near and dear, is really concerned for that too, you are sharing with them, that you know better way to whom you want to share what. This course definitely help you in this regard to make you understand your things, what you are sharing as an information with the group, and make you allotted how these need to be taken care wisefully, so that you will not face any difficulties, any problem, or encountered with any kind of unnecessary things which make your life miserably challenging. What I understand always, whatever activities we are doing with our mobile phones and our desktops using internet, it may be your certified internet connection or maybe public Wi-Fi. These are the things nowadays you need to do your activities in a systematic way, wisefully, where you can make yourself more secure. We are doing a lot of financial transactions. We are using Facebook, we are putting our photographs, we are sharing our valuable articles. Sometimes same device, we are carrying our valuable documents as digital copy. And knowingly, unknowingly, it is connected and giving access to X and Y and Z, who can catch up your all these valuable documents and make you in a trouble and at that time you will feel that what I am doing and how it has been happened and how I will overcome from that. First of all, this entire 4 weeks training program course making you understand and realize that how you can make more protective, as like as you are trying to protect yourself from summer, winter, as well as when you are moving out, that time you are taking care of many things about yourself, whether you will not encounter and attacked by any person which is make you in a trouble. Similarly, every moment, every individual, we are putting many things as digital footprint, and which can be making you and taking you in that level where how you will understand and how you will take up all these things more secured and keeping yourself in a barrier free from the digital crime. So, my dear friends, without taking much time, I would like to share with you this 4 weeks MOOC intensively prepared for the preliminary level of the participants who at least they understand about the different digital steps which make yourself more secure, more safe, and further, it also expected that you will be taking off with your students, your colleagues, so that they can also get benefited out of this. With these words, I wish all the best for this 4 week training program as MOOC, and I wish for your successful completion of this MOOC, and everyone should get your certificate, which will be helpful for your career and making yourself trustworthy in a future and digital world. Thank you very much. Over to Jitendraji.
Thank you, Manasji. Thank you very much. Now, I just want to demonstrate how to use this LMS for consuming this course, right? So I'm sharing my screen. Is it visible? Manasji, is it visible now?
Yes, yes.
Okay. So this is the landing page. The website is elearning2.uou.ac.in. Once you click on this link, you land into this page. If your login is already created, then you can directly put your username and password here. Otherwise, in case you don't have any login for this portal, you can create a new account. Create a username, password, you put your email ID, first name, city, town. You have to fill some details. Then you create a new account. Once the account is created, you will land again into this page and you have to fill your username and password. You will land into this page. You click Digital Forensics Cycle 2. Just in case this course is not visible on your page, you just go to Site Home, where you will find all the courses that are available in this portal. So you select Digital Forensics Cycle 2. So this is the landing page. We have announcement about this course, discussion forum. This is the discussion forum. It is mandatory to participate in the discussion forum, right? So you can create new link, new discussion topic here. You can put your queries. You have to post it to the forum, and the queries that are placed here that will be answered by the experts, right? Then this is course introduction. And now I have released first lecture, Introduction to Digital Forensics, right? In order to see the second lecture, that is cybercrime, first you have to complete the first lecture. Otherwise, you will not be able to see the third or second lecture directly, right? So this is organized this way, so that you access these videos sequentially. So at the end of every week, you will be having a quiz that you have to attend, right? So all the 4-week contents are populated in this course page, but you will be able to see only those links that are enabled by us, right? Since this is an admin page, so all the links are visible here, but in your course page, only the first module is visible, right? You cannot see until and unless we enable them from here, right? So it have 4 quizzes that you have to clear with more than 50%. Suppose you are not able to score 50% in the first 10 attempt, you can re-attempt, right? Apart from this, there is a provision of live sessions also. Whatever queries you have in your mind, you can put it, post it in discussion forum that will be answered by our experts. And apart from that, we have live sessions which are scheduled every Saturday at 6 p.m. where all the 5 experts will be present live. We'll share the Zoom link with you all to the Telegram group and the announcement section. And you can ask the question directly from the expert, that your queries will be resolved by the experts, right? And once you complete all the courses, once you consume all the videos, all the material, and you complete all the quizzes, under discussion forum, a certificate, download certificate link will be available. And you can click and download the certificate of participation once you complete all the formalities. We have also prepared a short video on how to complete this course that is already shared in the Telegram group. I'll share it again. It's a 2-minute, 3-minute video. Just go through it so that you will know what are the mandatory conditions to get the certificate. So that was all about the learning management system. We have also configured a Moodle app. You can also access this course using your smartphone. You just have to go to Play Store, download Moodle app, and the procedure for accessing this course using this Moodle app is also demonstrated in a video. It's a 2-minute video that I have already shared in the Telegram group. I'll share it again, right? So you can access this course in your computer as well as in your smartphone using app. So this was a small information about this course and how to access and consume the course using this LMS. So as I've already stated that we have also created a Telegram group. A link to join the Telegram group is sent to all the participants via email. You can join those links and you can get the updates from the instructors as well as the admin. So now the first lecture is released. You can access the course on the website and we'll meet again live on Saturday at 6 p.m. So I wish you all a very successful learning experience. So thank you very much. I thanks all the instructors and the mentors for sparing their valuable time to join this session. That's all from my side. Thank you. Thank you very much.
If any question, can we take a few questions if they want to?
In case you have any query in your mind regarding this course, please raise your hand so that I can, you know, allow you to ask the question.
Jitendraji, I just forgot to mention, a lot of people have an inhibition that is it mandatory to know the cyber security before getting into forensics. Yes, it is an added advantage if you know, but if you are not exposed to cyber security, there will be some session which will be included, and it can be conducted especially separately. So that's what I wanted to mention, which I forgot to in my just introductory talk. Thanks, Jitendra.
Thank you, sir. There is a question from G. Panwar. You can please ask your question. Any questions? Manaji, I think it's the first day and they have not started exploring the course. We have Dr. Akashdeep also with us, sure. Who is mentor, who is also mentoring this course. Welcome, Akashdeep ji.
Thank you, sir. So welcome to everyone to this wonderful course. So digital forensics, it's a passion for me. Primarily, it's a process of identifying, preserving, analyzing, documenting any digital evidence. Now, that is the process that we follow is done to present this evidence in court of law, right? Whenever we want to, you know, go after bad guys. So it's a process of uncovering, interpreting electronic data. Now, the application of science, as we apply them, the tools are there. The idea is to identify, collect, examine, analyze data, and of course, preserve that integrity of that information, since we want to maintain a strict chain of custody, as we call it. The first rule within digital forensics is primarily to preserve original evidence. Okay, and the process that we follow is for computers, mobile forensic investigations. So I'll be here to guide you, mentor you, help you in any way that you want. So welcome to your journey towards digital forensics, and all the best.
Thank you, Dr. Akashdeep. So if the participants have any question in your mind, you can raise your hand. We'll permit you to ask those questions. Otherwise, yes, Mr. Arif, if you have any question, please ask.
Hello. Yeah, good morning. Yeah, thank you. Thank you for this wonderful course. My question is, this is just online recorded sessions, or there will be any live sessions also?
There are live sessions every Saturday at 6 p.m. So there will be total four live sessions.
But Saturday is only a doubt clearing session, right?
You mean the course content? No.
Yeah, the course content.
Course content are pre-recorded only.
Only recorded sessions.
Yeah, okay. Yeah.
Okay. All right. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Ms. Tanvi Jain. You can please ask your question.
You can type if your mic is.
Yes.
Sir, Gaurav here. And my query is, will we have any practical hands-on sessions? Like we came to know we will be recreating the missing files or such. So we will have any practical sessions on that, like hands-on session where we can do this experiment kind of thing or lab practical kind of thing?
Yes. We have tried to use open source technology, right? So what we can do here, because We don't have any virtual labs for this. What we'll do is we'll tell you the requirements that the software you require, open source software, and we'll demonstrate. Our instructor will demonstrate, and then you can replicate, right? So lab sessions are there, but it will be in the demonstration mode. Manasvi Agarwal, do you have any question? Yeah, we have unmuted you.
Good morning, sir. Sir, I have a question that in the UOU learning platform, we have one survey that we have to fill with enrollment number. So, sir, where can we get the enrollment number?
You can skip or you can fill any random number there if you don't have, right? Because normally the enrollment number is for the students who are registered in the ODL courses that we offer. For online courses, currently we don't have any enrollment number. So you can type any random number. Okay. Thank you. Ms. Tanvi Jain.
So I want to ask, is this course useful for a 12th pass student?
Why not? I mean, it's a skill-based course. It will increase your understanding about forensics, digital forensics, right?
Okay, sir.
So it is useful.
And is there any pre-knowledge required?
No. If you have, basic computer knowledge is required. You know how to operate computer and what is operating system or what is hardware, software?
I have CS Python in 12th.
Okay, then that is sufficient.
Okay, sir.
Next question, please. Mr. Sneha Sheesh, you can ask your question, please.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning.
This is Sneha, sir.
Yes.
Sir, my question is, how I get a certificate after the end of the session?
You can download it from the portal itself. You will see towards the last week, you will see a link called download certificate. If you clear all the
quizzes
and you participated in the discussion forum also, and then you give the feedback, then you can directly download the certificate.
Another question. How many life lessons are to be taken in this overall session?
Life sessions, 4.
Okay. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. Gaurav.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Okay. Mr. Gaurav. You have any question? Mr. Khan, you can ask your question, please.
Sir, good morning, sir.
Good morning.
I am working as an assistant director in State Forensic Science Laboratory, okay. Bihar. Sir, I want to know ki any hands-on training on new fields such as the drone forensic and chip level forensic in mobile.
Actually, this course is designed to cater the needs of the students of MSc Cybersecurity. So this course is basically mapped to the curriculum. So currently, we don't have this advanced topic in this course, but we are planning. We are very soon going to host this course on SWAM platform also. Maybe by that time, if we'll get some experts who are willing to record on those topics also, then we'll definitely do those topics.
Firstly, I joined this course because I am currently pursuing as a MSc in cybersecurity from Odisha Open University.
Okay. OSOU.
So I'm joining this course.
Okay. Okay.
Okay. Thank you, sir.
Okay. Thank you. Mr. Suhas, you can ask your question, please. Mr. Suhas.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning.
Sir, I wanted to ask that whether we will get study material in the form of PDF or something.
Yeah, it is in already available in this portal in the form of PDF. The last link after each lecture, video lecture, is the study material related to that topic. You can directly download.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So we have in total 20 modules. So we'll release them one by one.
Yes, sir.
Right.
Thank you, sir.
Okay, welcome. Manfi Agarwal, you have any doubt again? Mr. Deepak Tiwari, you can ask your question, please.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning.
Sir, first of all, thank you so much for running such a beautiful course for the awareness of people like us. My query is already somebody else has asked. I was asked.
Okay. So
you have already answered that.
Okay. Thank you. Ms. Monica Thakur.
Sir, what's the certificate criteria? Is there any attendance?
See, we don't have any attendance criteria, but you cannot attempt the quiz until and unless you have gone through all the videos of that module. So indirectly, you have to, you know, see all the videos. Then only you will be able to attempt the quizzes. And until and unless you clear all the quizzes, all the four quizzes, and submit the feedback form and participate in the discussion forum, you will not be able to download the certificate. So we don't have any classroom type requirement that you have to be present, you know, when the instructor is present live, because since it is offered as a MOOC, so it gives you the flexibility of any time, anywhere learning. You have to consume all the videos, the text material. So indirectly there is a attendance requirement, but not, you know, synchronous sessions are not conducted asynchronously.
Okay, sir.
Manishri Agarwal, you have some doubt in your mind?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Sir, I want to ask that where can we get the course schedule?
Schedule, I mean, the contents are already populated in the web page, the course page.
Yes, sir.
We don't have any specific schedule because we have already populated the pre-recorded lectures that you have to consume in your own pace. The only requirement is you have to, the only schedule requirement is you have to attend the live sessions that I have already stated that they are scheduled every Saturday at 6 p.m. A separate email and the link will be sent to you via email, via Telegram group, and via announcement on the LMS page.
Okay, thanks, sir.
Any other question, please? Mr. Prajapati, please ask your question.
Thank you, sir, for organizing such kind of particular course. I would like to ask, sir, if you are getting some time, right? So can you please release all the weak material, right? And
yes, we'll release. Don't
sure. Just based on that Saturday, Sunday, right? If somebody is getting extra time, he or she can finish that before the time.
By evening, I'll release the lectures of first week by the evening, positively. Okay. Mr. Anu?
Hello.
Yes.
Thank you, sir, for providing this type of course. And I want, sir, hello.
Yes, yes.
Can we speak in Hindi, sir?
Yes, 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 please.
सर हमें ये पूछना था कि इसमें जो आप टेस्ट लोगे सर वो कब कब होगा टेस्ट सर क्विज बेसिस पे
क्विज जो होगा वो भी आप एसिंक्रोनस मोड में किसी वक्त भी कर सकते हैं आपको एक टाइम लाइन दी जाएगी कि इतने दो दिन या तीन दिन के अंदर आपको करना है सैटरडे को रिलीज होगा हर सैटरडे को सुबह रिलीज हो जाएगा
तो सर ये लाइव सेशन अटेंड करना होगा या फिर हम ऑफलाइन भी कर सकते हैं
लाइव सेशन रन कीजिए तो शाम को है अगर आपको कोई डाउट है तो आप उनको क्लियर कर सकते हैं और क्विज तो आप कभी भी कर सकते हैं जैसे आपको रिलीज कर दिया हमने कहा कि 5 दिन के अंदर सबमिट करना आप किसी को भी कर सकते
ओके थैंक यू सर
और कुछ क्वेरीज हैं देयर आर सम क्वेरीज फ्रॉम लर्नर्स दे वांट अस टू इनेबल चैट फीचर इन द टेलीग्राम ग्रुप एक्चुअली टेलीग्राम ग्रुप हैव अ डिफरेंट यू नो इंटेंशन राइट For resolving with your queries, we have discussion forums and live sessions. Telegram group are meant for one-way communication from instructor to the learners to broadcast the important messages. Otherwise, I mean, it is very difficult to handle Telegram group with more than 800 participants, right? So if you have any queries, you post it on discussion forum. Because people are there who will be handling them. Right? So it is not possible. Yes, any other question? Ms. Tanvi Jain. Yes.
Sir, I want to ask what we can expect from this course. I mean, what are the limitations?
See, it is a basic course of which will introduce you about digital forensics, what it is, what are the basic tools that are required. And if you are interested, you can further explore that specific tool or, you know, technologies, right? So it will give you a brief understanding of what digital forensics is all about.
Sir, can we become expert or just a beginner? As you
we
said,
we introduce you with various tools. You have to master that tools with practice. It will come with practice, right?
Okay, sir. Sir, so can we stay in touch? Okay, sir. So can we stay in touch after the end of course?
Yes, yes. The discussion forum is, is open. You can post your queries afterwards also.
Sir, will you answer someone?
Yeah, we monitor it.
Okay.
Any other questions?
So, sir, doubts only happen once a week.
Live sessions. Otherwise, asynchronously, you can post your queries in discussion forum. The link is there in the course page.
Sir, actually, I go through the discussion forums, but there were so many questions that were left unanswered.
Because they are, most of the time, they are, you know, duplicate. You can access all the questions, right? Okay. So duplicate questions or generic questions which are already answered, so they are avoided. Maybe, I mean, if the instructor will find time, because the course have started from today, right? So,
okay, sir.
These will be answered. Because some of them, they are introduction message. The people are introducing themselves, right? So no need to reply to those questions.
Okay, thank you, sir.
Mr. Mahesh, please ask your question.
Sir, good morning, sir.
Yes, good morning.
Sir, what is the name of the web page to access the course, sir?
E-learning 2, the number 2, sir. E-learning 2. Dot UOU dot AC dot N, right?
Okay, sir. Oh, okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
E-learning 2.uou.ac.in. I have shared the link in the chat box. Any other question? Monica, yes, please ask.
Sir, is there any proper way for accessing this course?
What?
Sir, is there any proper app for access this course?
Yes, yes. I'll share the video that we have recorded, how to access this course using Moodle app, right?
Sir, please can you send again this video in the Telegram channel?
Yes, yes, I'll send. Don't worry.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Any other question?
Sir, is this course free or paid?
It's free.
Okay, sir. Thank you. Thank you.
Any other question from any other participant? No more questions? Shall we call it a day now?
Yes, Jitanji, please.
Okay, thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you, all the instructors, the mentors, and Manasji for sparing your valuable time. I thank you once again. Thank you, all the participants. See you Saturday evening at 6 p.m. again. Thank you. Now I am signing off. Thank you.